I've been joined in studio by Mr. George Quaye. He speaks for Shatta House, organizers of the Vodafone Ghana Music Awards. And Emmanuel Ajiman is also a producer here at Media General. He produces specifically Enije Mre on Onuya 95.1 FM. Gentlemen, welcome. Good morning. How are you doing, George?
Good morning, Johnny, and great. Congratulations on the little working
day. Thank you. Right. Thank you very much. I've not had good sleep.
Welcome to the table.
Quickly, let me read for you. My welcome as well.
Thank
let me
you,
read
boss.
For you what okay. the VGMA board yesterday decided following the fracas that happened at the 20th VGMA. It says, both Livingstone, H.A. Setekla, a.k.a. Stonebwoy, and Charles Niyama Mensah, a.k.a. Shatawale, are hereby banned indefinitely from participating in the nominations, selections, and performances at the Vodafone Ghana Music Awards Scheme 2. The two artists are also hereby stripped of all awards they won on the night and are to return all plaques in their possession to Shatta House effective immediately. The two top honors of the night, that is the most popular song of the year and artiste of the year, have for the 20th edition of the Vodafone Ghana Music Awards been annulled. So that's it. George, first question to you. Have the artists returned the plaques?
The information went out just yesterday. But I do not know if any have been returned yet. I haven't been informed of anything of that nature. But they are gentlemen, and I trust they will.
I'm sure you've heard a few commentaries following the announcement of the board that, you know, people are confusing the two. That well, it means that you have, even though Madame Aliyah, they said that not that you have severe relationships with the two, people still go on and push out there. What have you heard? And what do you say to them?
A lot of people think that it's it means it's a total bye-bye to the scheme, that the two acts, arguably some of the biggest acts in GH today, have been severed off the VGMAs forever. It is not so at all. Indefinite was picked carefully, because even though you needed to put out a message that would serve as a deterrent to other musicians, up-and-coming acts and other acts that are, you know, that submit their works for awards considerations year in and out. Consultations are still broadly ongoing with various stakeholders, and even the ministry is leading a mediation process that the scheme believes would foster better relationship among these two acts and their fans. That is why it was said indefinite. Indefinite simply means that even tomorrow they could be recalled back to the scheme.
Right.
Monday, next year, 10 years time. Indefinite simply means that you do not put a specific time frame on it, so that when all matters were resolved and all parties were satisfied and happy, they could be recalled to the scheme. The idea is not to alienate them from the scheme. The idea is to find a way, because these gentlemen, they are not friends, bottom line, and the what is between them is serious. And if industry does not find a way to fix it, to bridge it, and their fan bases continue to rise the way they do, and you know, express the kind of angst and irateness and you know, the way they go at each other, if we do not find a way to curb it, it might degenerate into something more serious.
I said this 4 years ago, that this was going to degenerate into this, and I was told the likes of Bulldog or Ting and all of them, Sami Flex, they told me on Plaza FM at the time that, oh, it's part of the dancehall culture. It's okay. It's good for their business. Beefing is okay, blah, blah, blah. Today, they are the same people, you know, asking that, you know, this perhaps is too hard. But Ima, you are an entertainment pundit.
Okay.
Do you side with the decision of the board to ban these two, strip them of the awards, and annul the top two that were supposed to have been announced?
Okay, so for me, I think it is no. I don't agree with Shatta House.
Because it's not Shatta House, it's the VGMA board.
VGMA board, but they work for Shatta House. Okay, so let me use VGMA. Okay, so let me use VGMA board. Now, for me, I think they were supposed to at least give Stonebwoy and Shatta a fair hearing.
Which is the artist signed onto an agreement.
Yes.
If you bought a platinum ticket or you got one for free, you would see a small card that details
because
the do's and don'ts.
Because Johnny,
they signed on to it, they agreed to it.
Yes, they agreed
and
to
they flouted.
It.
What's
yes,
fair
but there were a lot of lapses from the organizers that we need to talk about.
Including
security.
Were you at the event?
I was not at the event.
But you know there were lapses?
Oh, yes, I know. Because
like which one? How do you know there were lapses when you were there?
Now, in terms of security, now, Shatta Wale has a place he's supposed to sit. He enters the auditorium and then he decides to sit at a place he wants to be. Meanwhile, the scheme or the VGMA has a particular place Shatawale is supposed to sit. Now we allow him to sit there. Nobody tells him that, no, we don't do it like that. We are working. It has to be in order. Everything has to be in order. This is where you are supposed to sit. Now he goes to sit there. Nobody tells him, no, you can't be here. Now Stonebwoy is being called on stage to come and pick an award. He walks from there and he tells us that he was going to the VIP. Is it not a security lapse? Because see, Johnny, when Stonebwoy was going on stage, I've watched a lot of footages from people who actually recorded with their mobile phones. And you see, when Stonebwoy was actually going there, he went there, there were security in front of the stage. So when Shatawale was coming, I don't know the communication between VGMA and the security who were dispatched in the venue. I don't know
have you bothered to ask?
No, you see, because there were some agreement, there was some communicate that you are not supposed to go on stage if you have not been called.
You will respond. Because
he wasn't there, and there's a lot of miscommunication that's happening right.
So I'll come to you. Let him land quickly. Wrap up for me.
Now, Shatawale decided to go on stage, and the two security we saw in the video, they couldn't stop him, and he took Sidi.
Okay.
The manager of Stonebwoy to come and stop him, and then it turned into something else.
Okay. George, quickly, number one, was it an agreement you had with Shatawale and his manager to have him seated at the back?
Yesterday,
or did you make arrangement at the front for him?
Yesterday on another radio station, it came out clearly that earlier in the day, Shatta's manager, Chris Connie, had spoken to a protocol, the lady in charge of protocol. They had raised a thought that Shatta would like to sit with his fans, and they made it explicit right there and then that no, it's not possible.
Okay.
Because seats had been reserved for all the nominated artists, and this is a TV station. You work here, you work here. You know where you put people for various purposes at events like this. You like to pick them. So to start with, it wouldn't be in the best interest of organizers for any act to sit where they prefer.
Right.
So erroneously, he was not allowed to sit where he wanted to sit.
He did as he pleased.
He did as he pleased. When they mentioned it, they even told them that no, it's not going to happen. However, when you come for sound check, would escalate it, because the entire team would be there.
Okay.
So would escalate it and discuss with the rest of the team and see what can be possible. Because there was a clear barricade.
Okay.
So where he was going to sit, it would mean that even if he won an award, he would have to jump over the barricade or get out, and it was going to be cumbersome. So that was not going to be allowed in the first place. But they still violated it. He still went to sit where he was. And we need not even go into what happened.
Did this discussion, escalated discussion following the sound check, did it happen?
It didn't happen. They did not turn up for sound check at all.
Okay, he didn't come.
No, they didn't turn up for sound check at all. So that discussion did not happen. So as far as the team was concerned, he was coming to sit at his designated position.
Right.
Now again, you'd notice that when the two first awards were announced, which was like, an hour into the program?
Yeah, exactly.
The two that he won, he did not come on stage to pick them up, because even as at that time, he had not arrived.
He wasn't there, true.
So the show was ongoing when they arrived. They arrived somewhere in the middle of the show. I think Sydney was on stage performing when they arrived.
No, before Sydney.
Somewhere
I was sitting with Pajon and Nana Benyi Dazin when he came in at the back. So and, it was just around that time before I came backstage to see.
And even at that time, I hear there was some scuffle because people know this is not where you're supposed to be, and it happened and all that. So my brother, it was not that people did not try to stop him from going to sit where he wanted. However, if the people had used the kind of brute force that people are expecting that should have been used, it would have degenerated into another issue where the headline today would have been Shatawale stopped from attending VGM.
George, the security lapse has come up, and at some point, I think that your organization has admitted that
there were issues. It could have been
About that. And people are asking questions. I, for example, I was in Scant, not even once. I came through the main gate, I went through another gate, I went through the backstage, I wasn't scanned even once. That's dangerous. Somebody says anybody could have entered and sporadically started shooting because of the threats.
You're absolutely right, that is wrong. And again, I've been on other radio stations where people have indeed confirmed that they were scanned when they were coming in. Is that, which one do they call it? The one they used to?
Yeah, it's a scanner.
The metal detectors.
You know, because they were there, it was part of the security plan. But again, one shows that some of us are stuck backstage. So I cannot say for sure that everybody was scanned. Again, we know the situation with sometimes as creative personnel and popular faces like yours. Mm. They've seen Johnny Hughes. They wouldn't expect Johnny Hughes to, which is wrong, but we are still looking into it. We're still investigating. Mm. How come some people were scanned? Because right now, if we speak and you have a phone call you can call, I can give you about 15 names of people who have confirmed that indeed they were scanned. Mm. You understand? So clearly, it's not everybody who was scanned. Why? We are still investigating and would better it going forward. However, I would plead with all of us that we should not find an excuse in a security lab to justify an act that brought us all where we are today. Mm. You were there and you saw the commotion when they were coming in.
Right.
You have clearly stated clearly, even though that manual, that instruction manual on the card, you know, made it explicit that when it was not your turn, you had no business on stage. You did not have to go there.
You don't move around.
It was stated there clearly.
The doors are open during commercial break.
To ensure that we all abide by this rule.
Why aren't we looking at it this way? How come everybody ensured that they followed the rules and regulations? Please, let us not make it look like we're dealing with kindergarten children. They are adults in the auditorium. I mean, the processes that led to that event, there were various interactions with Shatta's camp. Again, let us not make it look like Shatta Wale was the only one who was wrong. Both acts were wrong.
Sure, right.
For organizer's side, security and protocol could have been better, admitted.
Okay.
But let us not cower under the fear of some fan base or anything to push things under the carpet. The gentleman had no business getting up.
Okay. Sure.
The other gentleman had no business showing up.
Okay, George, quickly, some school of thought says that if they were in a category together and maybe artist of the year, popular song of the year, and they were disqualified for some reason, the next in line should have been given awards and not a total annulment as has been done by the board.
Annulment as has been done by the board was not taken just to maybe pass it on to somebody else. No. Why was it annulled? It was annulled because you saw the encounter. You were there. You watched on TV. You saw the kind of encounter when even a category that wasn't the major or one of the big categories on the night was announced.
Reggae dancehall artist.
Now imagine if the overall artist was of the year was announced and it was either of these two. Imagine the kind of pandemonium. And you see people are sitting back saying, oh, and this is BIM Nation and this is that, and all the angst and agitation on social media and all this. For every line that you see on social media, there's a human being behind it. There's a face behind it.
Sure.
These people are real. This fanaticism and everything, it is real. So annulment of those two categories, it is to secure.
Could we have given it to the next in line? I compete with Ima, you disqualify me. Ima because has the next highest vote.
The next in line did not win the categories.
Yeah.
Okay.
The people that won the categories exist. And that is why when people agitate for return the monies, I do not subscribe.
In football, if I'm disqualified, the opposing side gets the...
This is not football.
Is it not?
This is not football.
So,
neither is it a beauty pageant.
Okay.
Now, I was explaining the fact that
The
reason for annulment is not just because of what they did, which, let's all face it, was very dishonorable to that stage.
Mm.
And yes, as a punitive measure, it is fair that it is annulled. However, beyond that punitive measure, there is also the need to ensure that there's public order. And there is fear. Look, Johnny, that evening, after the agitation and everything, before later categories, the decision that led to holding back or muting any other category that involved those two was something that was decided with security. Because if you had gone outside the main gate, the people that were there from either faction and all the anger and charge and everything, it was important that those two categories especially were muted until some order has been restored. So again, I said earlier that the indefinite was chosen carefully. There's consultations and mediations that are going to happen. Once everything is resolved, who knows? Moving forward, maybe the winners of those two categories can be announced when we're confident that it is not going to degenerate into any clashes.
Okay, so the school of thought, I have heard Bulldog say you should have called them to have a conversation with them prior to serving them this notice. By the way, have you written officially to Stonebwoy and Shatta Wale?
Yes, I believe the letters are being dispatched as we speak.
They are being dispatched now. But Bulldog called, says, well, you should have had a conversation with them, sit down sort of with them. Do you agree?
When you mentioned that you were taking a tangent with us, I subscribe to. before the event, there were various engagements, and I'm sure you probably saw some of the pictures on Shatta's own Instagram wall.
Right. Yeah.
All these engagements was to help them or let them understand what this 20th anniversary meant for everybody and what was expected of them.
Mm.
There were engagements with Sarkodie, there were engagements with Shatta Wale, with Samini, Stonebwoy was out of town at the time and all that, and so many other stakeholders. Beyond that, there were, I'm sure you saw my push at the experience Shatta's camp and all that. So after all these, you know, we invited Shatta's camp in. Chris Conner will testify to this. There was an extensive discussion of the security detail, the plan, the expectations and everything. Various expectations were held. The letters, the nominee letters that were sent to them, you know, pointed out certain details. Beyond that, there was a nominee briefing that was held at Alisa Hotel for all nominees about how they should comport themselves and everything that was required of them on the night of the event.
So you didn't expect
so many engagements ahead of the event. So if after all these, you still violate, what engagement again is there? What again is there to be discussed?
For most of you who are entertainment pundits, the argument of some sane thinking people of the public think that you are the cause of our problems, because half of the time entertainment pundits speaks without facts, half of the time they are instigating and, you know, pushing people to take a certain action, half of the time they have their favorites and they are hitting at people. Is it the case?
Oh, yes.
Are you to blame the entertainment pundits?
Yes, of course. It's likely we have to blame most of the entertainment pundits we have, because even some entertainment pundits, some subscribe to Shatta Wale, some are Stonebwoy. So when issues are put on the table, in fact, if I'm for Shatta or Stonebwoy, in fact, going and hating on the facts, people will just go to where they subscribe to. I'm Shatta fan. So if Shatta do something VGMA night and it's not good, we have to condemn it, instead of entertainment pundit to condemn because they subscribe to Shatta Wale and for Stonebwoy, they begin to speak for them. But for me, it is wrong. I think it's about time that media stations need to invest into entertainment programs that we have on radio and TV. Because if you are not investing in getting quality pundits to be on your show, it's going to cause a whole lot of things. Because sometimes you see, you just see someone on the street, the person can talk, you see the person writing so many things on social media, you feel when I bring the person on my show, this person can talk because he's been writing a lot of things about Shatta Wale, Stonebwoy. So when I get him on my platform, he's going to fly. But that is not how we go about
it.
We need to start grooming people, get the right people, because you need to do your research before you come on any entertainment platform you get as a fan.
George, I've seen your Shatta House's statement apologizing to everybody else and saying that going forward you have more security, you're engaging and all of that. But what punishment do you want to ascribe to yourselves as Shatta House, as VGMA? You've punished the boys, stripped them of the awards, banned them and annulled the two awards. What punishment would Shatta House give to itself?
Johnny, what punishment is bigger than what Shatta House is suffering at the moment? You're staring at the possibility of an event where no corporate institution may want to associate going forward. You're looking at a national humiliation globally. You're looking at people calling you and say, oh, Shatta House, I know you've done better. I know you could have done better. What punishment is worse than this? You're looking at months, weeks, even years of sweat almost gone down the drain. You're staring at the faces of your colleagues being rushed to the hospital just because somebody got up from his seat. You're looking at the hard work, you're looking at a beautiful setup, you're looking at a dome that you raised in 4 days to give Ghana a beautiful entertainment package that would be spoken about globally. You're looking at your name appearing in the Daily Mail UK and not for a good reason. You're looking at your story being told on BBC, not for a good reason. What punishment could be worse? I think Shatta House has been punished enough, and worst of all, even as it is now, like Iman rightly said, people, based on their affiliations or their love for one act or the other, are still refusing to accept the fact on the ground and state it as it is, and still skewed toward other things.
Okay.
It is unfortunate, but as an organization, rest assured, lessons have been learned, and going forward, things will be done better and everybody.
Thank
will.
You. Emmanuel Ajiman is an entertainment pundit and also a producer here at Media General. He produces the Media Mirror on Unia 95.1 FM Thursdays and Saturdays from 1 p.m. till 4 p.m. You can always tune in and listen. And George Quaye speaks for Shatta House, the official mouthpiece. George, don't go and cry anywhere again.